Welcome back to the Lanterne Rouge YouTube channel. Obviously, Ineos sponsor the most successful cycling team, so I thought Eliud Kipchoge's 1:59 record was within my remit. First of all, congrats to Kipchoge, obviously a massive event, but the main reason that Kipchoge was able to run sub 2 hours for the marathon were these Nike Vaporfly prototype shoes. These pink shoes that he was wearing and that all the Ineos 1:59 guys were wearing, those shoes are the difference between him running his 2 hours and 3 minutes pre-Vaporfly record, his personal record, and then his current PB in Berlin, the 2 hours, 1 minute and 39 seconds record where he was wearing the 4% original edition Vaporflies. But for the 1:59 challenge, they brought out a new prototype. I'm not sure whether it's called 5% or 6%. And there are some leaked photos of the prototype being tested out, as you can see in the shot here. But in this video, I want to talk about how these running shoes actually make such a difference and are the difference between running 2 hours and 3 minutes and below 2 hours. And here you can see the prototype construction and all the patterns here. And as I showed in the thumbnail, the shoe has an incredibly large stack. And that stack, according to this mock-up, is comprised of three carbon plates that sit on top of each other, and between the three carbon plates are two foam pads. So I'll go on to explain the effect of this on performance. So obviously when Kipchoge's foot impacts the ground, that those carbon plates, they impact the foam and can create like a spring effect to improve his running economy. So what is running economy? Well, it's the energy demanded from an athlete for a given speed running below sprinting speed. And there's a number of factors that affect running economy. They include how efficient your biomechanics are, for how much energy is lost, other more physiological things like the metabolic adaptations in the mitochondria within your muscles, also the elasticity of your muscles, which create a natural spring effect. That's why a lot of runners now do strength training to try and reduce energy loss or the braking forces from impact. And in my view, these Vaporfly shoes are a technological workaround or a sidestep of those physiological adaptations that improve running economy, particularly strength training. It basically is a technological version of the effect of strength training on muscle elasticity. And you don't need to take my word for it. There's been a number of studies that have proven how effective these Nike Vaporflies are. Typically, people think, oh, everything's a marketing gimmick, and we're so conditioned as consumers to not really believe the hype around new innovative products. But the Vaporflies are actually legit, and they are actually worth the money, because this study shows, the link to this study is in the description, by the way, both of these studies. This study showed that the Nike Vaporfly shoe, when compared to the other best-in-class Adidas marathon shoe, had a 3% effect on running economy. And this is the old Vaporflies. This isn't the new prototype with the extra carbon plates and the massive, massive stack. So one would assume that the effect on running economy would be even higher with these new prototype shoes that Kipchoge was wearing for the 1:59 effort. And Ross Tucker on Twitter, the sports scientist, he actually put out a really useful graph. So if we assume that Kipchoge is a 2 hour and 3 minute marathoner, wearing normal shoes without the massive stack, not Vaporfly type shoes, that's his physiological limit right now, then the effect of these Vaporfly shoes basically means he can do a 1 hour, 59 minute and 48 second marathon. He obviously did better than that today, 1 hour, 59 and 40. I know it's really exciting, an athlete breaking such a barrier that seemed to be impossible to break, and people have put out YouTube videos talking about the physiological things that Eliud Kipchoge needs to do, but really this kind of reminds me of the Speedo LZR racer suits when they were introduced, the full body suits. And when they were introduced, Phelps used them, and I think 13 world records were broken in swimming in 1 month in 2008, and then later on in more months. And eventually FINA, the swimming body, decided they had to ban men wearing these full-length suits and create some sort of restrictions around the use of technology to destroy basically world records. Now the shoe that Kipchoge was using, it's not illegal to use at all. If he used it in a normal marathon race, I'd assume there'd be no problem with it at all, as he's been wearing Vaporflies, which he wore at Berlin for the 2 hour, 1 minute and 39 seconds. But I basically just wanted to make this video to let people know that it's not really a physiological improvement that is the reason why Kipchoge was able to run sub 2 hours. It was the technology in the shoes. It was probably the improved and ideal drafting behind the drafters. Probably the biggest takeaway apart from the shoes for me from his effort was the psychological pressure he must have been on. I said on my Instagram, if you want to check out that below, I think he was the athlete with the most pressure on him in 2019. I know it's a big call, but literally almost the whole world stopped to watch him run, and him alone. And it's not like if he started to fade, everyone would, you know, Berlin or London Marathon, they just keep watching the guys out front who are going to win the race. If he stopped or started fading, then everyone would have just been watching him fail. So massive psychological discipline from Kipchoge and just the mental fortitude he must have. The comment down below, let me know what you thought about the Ineos 159 challenge. Did you watch it? Did you think it was legit? Do you think it should be a world record? And you don't know why it's not a world record, because it's not done in race conditions. And I mean, I see the counter argument. I mean, my Bont cycling shoes, if these give me like a 3% better power transfer to the pedal because Bont have a really good, you know, carbon development system, should they be banned or should I be penalized for it? Should there be some limitations put in place if I have a tire manufacturer that allows me to have much less rolling resistance on my tires in cycling? Does that mean anything I do is less legit? Probably not in the cycling world. So it's an interesting discussion. Where do you see on the spectrum of legit or not legit the Vaporfly prototypes that Kipchoge was wearing? Where do they sit? Are they at the end of perfectly fine, just normal technological advancement, or the LZR racer suit for swimming that was just meant every previous world record got smashed out of the park? Thanks for watching. See you next time. Ciao.